President Muhammadu Buhari on Monday met behind closed doors with governors-elected under the platform of the All Progressives Congress, APC, at the State House, Abuja. The agenda of the meeting was unknown as at the time of filing this report. However, Governor Atiku Bagudu, who led the governors to the meeting with Buhari, announced the postponement of the APC National Executive Committee meeting earlier scheduled for Tuesday. Bagudu, who spoke with State House correspondent at the end of meeting, said the postponement was at the instance of the governors. The Speaker of the House of Representatives, Femi Gbajabiamila, had earlier met with the president behind closed doors at the State House. According to a source, the meeting between the president and Gbajabiamila was centered on the APC leadership crisis and the proposed $22.7 billion loan as it affects all the six geopolitical zones, particularly the Southeast. And joining me in the studio this evening to discuss this further is political analyst, Mr. Agbeloba. Thank you for staying with us on News on the Hour.
Thank you.
Now, did you see this postponement of the APC next meeting coming? Was there any handwriting in the world that it will be postponed?
From the moment the national leader of the party, the titular national leader of the party, Ashu Agbeloba Ahmed Tinubu, spoke yesterday, it was almost discernible that he must have gotten the nod of the president. You know, one of the paragraphs of the speech was that somebody who was ill-equipped to call the neck called it. So that was, for me, a sign that he could have gotten the nod of the president that the neck was not going to hold.
Now, it's glaring to all to see that APC is a house divided against itself with the current crisis rocking the house. In light of 2023, if things are not solved, how do you see this affecting the party come 2023 general election?
2023 is, at this juncture, a millennia away. To be honest with you, a millennium away, sorry.
3 years away.
A millennium away in politics. So many things can happen. But it is just a fact that in our polity, politicians in the ruling party always juggle the narcissistic ball to position themselves in a way that will give them the advantage when they are getting nearer the goalpost of when candidature would have to be defined and when elections would have to take place. So I'm sitting here now thinking, you know what? I don't want to get into the business of speculating. It's just that the combustible elements in APC now, if they don't rein themselves in, and the only person that has the wherewithal to rein them in is the president, because our politics is a largessocracy. And because it controls the pulse of the beneficence that majority of these politicians play to, he must be more assertive. It's just that in his case, he gets only assertive when matters affect him, but a bit aloof when matters affect the party. And if it goes on like that, we may not have APC in 2020.
All right, just before I let you go this evening, now, if the APC National Executive Committee finally removes Adams Oshiomhole as the national chairman, do you see this in any way solving the problem of the party?
Not at all. Not at all. In fact, it's going to be the whistle blown for the ultimate internecine wars of the party to further manifest. You must remember that the interests who want to remove Oshiomhole want to remove Oshiomhole because they believe Oshiomhole is not beholden to them. Interests like Bola Ahmed Tinubu, who believe that Oshiomhole is a masterpiece of their own political furnishing architecture in the governance of the party, would also go into extra calculative moves to also want to decapitate whoever comes on without their own anointment. So I'm seeing the intensification of the internecine wars if Oshiomhole were to be removed, especially in humiliating circumstances as it was almost going to be if tomorrow's neck were to hold.
Agbeloba, political analyst, thank you very much for joining us on News on the Hour.
Always a pleasure.